If you're wondering how to set up a Google Analytics account, you've come to the right place. In this video, I'll show you how to set up an account and how to add Google Analytics to your website. Hey friends, I'm Tasia and welcome to my YouTube channel where I share tech tips and app reviews. If you find value in this content, go ahead and give this video a like. It really does help to tell YouTube you've indeed found the content you're looking for. And speaking of finding the content you're looking for, today's video is going to show you how to create a Google Analytics account and how to add Google Analytics to your website. Now, there are a couple of really important troubleshooting tips to keep in mind as we go through the setup, depending on the website. So if you're really new to Google Analytics, we'll first cover what is Google Analytics, then we'll go into how to create a Google Analytics account, and then we'll of course cover how to add Google Analytics to your website. Specifically, we're going to cover how to add Google Analytics to a Wix site and how to add Google Analytics to a WordPress site. Let's go. So what is Google Analytics? Google Analytics is a free web analytics service offered by, you guessed it, Google. So in a nutshell, Google Analytics allows you to track and report website traffic, video, social network traffic, as well as measure your all-important return on investment, or ROI. So now that we have an understanding of what Google Analytics is, let's jump into how to create a Google Analytics account. It's really simple and takes just a few minutes, but I'm going to go through two very different, very important options during setup, depending on the type of website you have. So Google Analytics recently updated to Google Analytics 4, and some sites are compatible with this update and some aren't yet. So I'm going to show you both ways on how to do it because your analytics account here will look a bit different depending on your setup. But I promise, don't be confused, this will all make sense in a second. So, to create a Google Analytics account, head to google.com/analytics and simply click on Start for Free. Okay, now here you'll create an account by using the same Google info that you use for, you know, your Gmail. So the account that you want to track traffic for, like your business account maybe. You can also create an account here too if you don't even have a Google account yet. Once you're logged in, click Set Up for Free. Now here, add an account name. This can be your company name. And then scroll down past these data sharing options. I just like to have them toggled on. And then select Next. Here, you're going to provide some property details, including a property name. Now this is normally your website. So I'm gonna type in my business website. Okay, and then you'll select your time zone and currency. Now here's where that very important tip comes in, and this is crucial depending on the website you have. You may want to make sure you create a universal analytics property. Long story short, this here is now Google Analytics 4, which is a fairly new update, and some websites aren't updated to allow for this new tagging method. So for example, I have a Wix site and they don't yet support Google Analytics 4. So it's key that I have a universal property for that. Now, if you have a WordPress site, you don't need to worry as much about this. I'm gonna go over that in a second. We'll actually go over both versions for you guys. So we'll start with Wix and then we'll talk about what this looks like if you have a WordPress site. So underneath that currency option, you'll have this Show Advanced Options. This is your option to create a universal analytics property. If you're running a Wix site or want a universal tracking ID, make sure this is toggled on. Now go ahead and add the website URL here. And for a Wix site, you actually have to make sure that you toggle on the universal only option. Currently, as of January 2021, when I'm making this video, this is the only way to generate a tracking ID that works with Wix. So far. Now again, if you're on WordPress, you can select both options. It's really not a big deal, but we will get to that soon. So once you've got that all set, just click Next. Here, you can add additional business information. So how many employees, as well as some other checkboxes here for what you're looking to track. Then all you have to do is click create. And here in this pop-up, agree to the terms, and voila, you've successfully created a Google Analytics account. So it really takes about 1 minute to set up a Google Analytics account. And now that you know how to create an analytics account, it's time to add Google Analytics to your website. And you do this by installing the tracking ID or measurement ID. Now again, remember, there's different ways to do this depending on the site that you have. So I'm gonna walk you through a couple different options here so you at least understand where to find the code and what code you're looking for in your Google Analytics account, and then how to add that to your website. So in keeping with installing for a Wix account, if you selected the universal option, your screen is now going to look like this. For reference, we are in our admin console under the property we just created, and we are in the tracking code section. You're going to need to copy this tracking ID in the left corner. It's the UA dash followed by a bunch of numbers. Now, head on over to your Wix site dashboard and hover over marketing and SEO on the left-hand panel. Then select marketing integrations. Right here is an option to connect your Google Analytics account. So click connect. And here we see that Wix is warning us again that we can't use the new GA4 version of Google Analytics quite yet, which is why we chose that universal option. So go ahead and click the connect to Google Analytics here. And in this pop-up is where you're going to put in your tracking ID, that UA number you copied from your analytics. So paste in that tracking ID and toggle on the IP anonymization and click save. Voila, Google Analytics is now connected to your Wix website. Now you may not show that you've connected right away, so you can always go ahead and refresh your browser tab here. And then look, there we go. We've successfully connected Google Analytics to a Wix account. So now, as promised, we want to do the exact same thing, but we want to do this for a WordPress site, since that's probably what many of you are using. It's basically the same, but a little bit different. Here we go. Now, remember when we were back here in our Google Analytics and we were creating that property? So you have your property name, which can be the website, and you've set your time zone and your currency, but instead of toggling on that universal option like we did, you've left the advanced option toggled off here. Don't toggle it on at all. So now all you're gonna have to do is click next and select your business information like we did before, and then click create, accept the terms. And now, instead of having that tracking ID that's generated in the top left, you actually have to set up a data stream in order to start collecting the data that we want. So if you had already set up a Google Analytics account, but you didn't do this step yet, your screen might look a little different here. So just to give you an idea again of where we are within our Google Analytics account, we are in the admin portal in the property that we just created, but now we're in the data streams section. This is for GA4, okay? So it's a little bit different than that tracking ID section. So here we wanna choose our platform. We're gonna select web since we want to add Google Analytics to our website. So now from here, we have to set up this data stream, and we do so by adding our domain. So put your website URL in here. And then to the right, give the stream a name. So you might want to call this my website or business website or product site, whatever makes sense for your situation. So here underneath enhanced measurement, I recommend keeping this toggled on, but if you maybe want only a few of these and not all, you can actually just click this gear icon here and individually select which interactions you want automatically measured. So once you're happy with everything, just click create stream. So now we have a few more options here back in our web stream details. Google should generate a measurement ID up here in the right for you. And if you don't see this ID right away after doing this, it's okay. It might take you a minute, and you can always just go ahead and reload your analytics page and it should appear for you soon. The measurement ID is important because, like I said, depending on the website you have, you've got these different options for adding Google Analytics to your site. If we scroll down, you can also use these other tagging instructions for your site. And even within these tagging options, there's a couple different methods here. There's this global site tag, or there's this Google Tag Manager. I think the Google Tag Manager is a bit more robust, as you can send data to other non-Google areas as well. Either of those will work for WordPress sites. So if you're more comfortable copying and pasting, say, this code into the head of every web page you want to measure, then this section is for you. But I think we can be even simpler with this. And it's really easy to simply copy the measurement ID up here. This is this G code in the top right, just like we did with that tracking ID earlier. Now, since I don't have a WordPress site, I'm gonna show you guys a really detailed screenshot here of what this looks like on WordPress. It's literally as simple as it was for the tracking ID that we did for Wix. It's just using the measurement ID. Now, I've also put a link in the description below, and it's a detailed step-by-step from WordPress, just in case you need a little bit more guidance. So copy that measurement ID from your Google Analytics account, and now head over to your WordPress.com settings. Now, in your settings, go to Tools, then select Marketing, then Traffic. And you're gonna scroll down until you find the Google Analytics section. And this is what the section is going to look like here. And here you should be able to paste in that measurement ID. And then simply click Save Settings, and that's really all there is to it. So remember, there's more than one way to add Google Analytics to your website, but all said and done, it really should take you just a few minutes to set up a Google Analytics account and successfully add it to your site. Well, that's all there is to it. Did you guys find this video helpful? Would you like to know even more about Google Analytics? Let me know in the comments below. As always, thank you guys so much for watching. If you like this video, I wanna know. So give it a like, a share, or be sure to leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel and click up here for even more Google Analytics content. Thanks for watching, guys. See you next time.